problem is to write a Python program to check if a string is a number. That means float. Hello everyone, a very warm welcome to WsCube Tech. My name is Ayushi Jain. In this video, we will learn how to write a program that will allow us to check if a string, that is, if we have taken an input from a user as a string and a user writes a number, or if he writes a letter or anything, we need to check if that thing is a float or not. How to do it in Python is very simple. Let's have a look on this simple method to check it. First of all, we need to check it for a string. That's why I'll be creating a variable called as num, and inside this I'll be taking the input. I'm not taking this input in integer or in float. I'm taking it directly input. That means default value, that is our string. So that means whatever output will come over here, that would come in a format of a string. So input, enter something here. I'll be writing enter something here. Once a user has written something over here, what we need to check if it is float or not. For that, we have a very simple method. If I simply print float and num. Okay, this would not solve our problem, but just have a look on what can be done. So if I want to convert this into a float, for that I'll be writing print float and number. So if it is a number, then it will definitely get converted into a float. Even if it is an integer, then too it will get converted into a float. But what if it is a string? Let's have a look on what will happen if it is a string. So as soon as I run it, I'll get the output that enters something here, and I'll be writing hello. Or first of all, let's try with a number. So I'll be writing 1, 2, 3. And it will give me an output 123.0. That means the value is in the float. Now again, I'll be running this and enter something here, and I'll be writing hello. And if I press enter, it will throw me an error that could not convert string to float hello. Why? Because hello is an alphabetic order and we cannot convert alphabets into the numbers. Now for that, what we will be doing, we need to check that if this string is a float or not without throwing an error. For without throwing an error, we will be using our try and except method. I'll be creating a function over here, the def, and we'll be checking for the float. That's why I'll call it check float, and inside the parentheses I'll be passing the number. Okay, now what do we need to do? We need to write the code where the error might occur. So error will occur inside the try method. So in try and except, Python has two methods called as try and except, two statements called as try and except. In the try statement, we write the code in which the error might occur. And in the except, we write the code where what solution could come if the error occurs. Okay, so if I'll write float num. So in this case, what could happen? The error might occur, right? So if there is no error, then in that case, we will return true. Okay. But what if there is an error? In that case, I'll be writing the statement called as except. Inside the except, we will be passing return false. False will give us that the string cannot be converted into a float, and the true will give us that it can be converted into a float. Lastly, I'll be printing the name of our function, that is check float, and inside this I'll be passing num. Okay, now let's run and see what output we'll get here. So if I'll write enter something here, I'll be writing 1, 2, 3. If I write 1, 2, 3, it will give me true. While at the same time, if I write hello here, it should throw me error according to our previous program. But let's see what will happen now when we have written it inside the try and except method. So once I have pressed the enter, it is giving me false. False means what? That if there is error in this statement, it will execute this statement. That means it will give us false over here. Okay. So I hope guys that the method is clear to you, that how we can check if a string is float or not. All we need to do is take a user input called as num. Inside that we'll be writing input, enter something here. That means we'll be taking the input in the format of a string. We'll be creating a function called as check float. Inside that we'll be passing a parameter called as num, the one which we took as a user input. After that we will be using the try and except method. The try except method over here tells us that in the try we can write the code in which the error might occur. And the except method, we will be writing the code that what should happen if an error might occur to avoid the error to happen. Lastly, we will be writing print statement. In the print statement, we will be writing the check float, that is the name of our function, and we will be calling the number over here. That means whatever the number we have given as an input. So I hope guys, you guys have no doubts in the questions. The link of this code is present in the description. And for more such interesting videos, stay connected guys. Thank you.